In the previous video, we learnt about the causes or various events that led to this devastating war in history, popularly known as the Second World War. Let's retrace on a map a summary of the main events of World War II. At the end of World War I, Germany and its allies were defeated and held solely responsible for the war. With heavy sanctions imposed upon them, the Austro-Hungarian and Ottoman empires were dismantled, while Germany has to repay heavy debt. Severely weakened, Germany sees a rise of nationalism in 1933 that allowed the rise of power of the Nazi Party with Adolf Hitler at its helm. With the help of Hitler, Germany grew powerful in 1938 and annexed Austria, west of Czechoslovakia and Poland, which provoked United Kingdom and France to declare a war, marking the beginning of World War II. In this video, we will learn about the various phases of the Second World War, which changed history like no other event did in the modern era. The Phoney War was an 8-month period at the start of World War II, marked by no major hostilities, with no land operations undertaken by the Allies or the Germans after the German conquest of Poland in September 1939. Contrast with the Blitzkrieg or Lightning War, this war was labeled as Zitzkrieg or the Boer War. Historians believe that this period saw very little action, as all countries involved were biding their time and waiting for the other to make the first move. Although there was no large-scale military action by Britain and France, they did begin some economic warfare, especially with the naval blockade, and shut down German surface radars. The quiet of the Phoney War was punctuated by a few Allied actions. In the Saar Offensive in September, the French attacked Germany with the intention of assisting Poland, but it fizzled out within days and they withdrew. In November 1939, Soviets tried to take territory from Finland, which fights back in the Winter War. Finland loses war and much of its territory but maintain independence. On 23rd of August 1939, in order to avoid a possible Soviet-German conflict, Germany and Union of Soviet Socialist Republics signed a Treaty of Non-Aggression, which provided a written guarantee of peace between each party. The Allied discussions about a Scandinavian campaign caused concern in Germany and resulted in the German invasion of Denmark and Norway in April. On the Axis side, the Germans launched attacks at sea in the autumn and winter against British aircraft carriers and destroyers, sinking several, including the carrier HMS Courageous, with the loss of 519 lives. There were various minor bombing raids and reconnaissance flights on both sides. Germany quickly overran much of Europe and was victorious for more than 2 years by relying on this new military tactic of Blitzkrieg, also known as the Lightning War. Blitzkrieg tactics required the concentration of offensive weapons such as tanks, planes, and artillery. These forces would drive a breach in enemy defenses, permitting armored tank divisions to penetrate rapidly and roam freely behind enemy lines, causing shock and disorganization among the enemy defenses. In May 1940 came Germany's invasion of Belgium, the Netherlands and France, during which the German army used the combined force of tanks, mobile infantry and artillery troops to drive through the Ardennes forest and quickly penetrated the Allied defenses. With close air support from the Luftwaffe, German Air Force, and the benefit of radio communications to aid in coordinating strategy, the Germans blazed through northern France and toward the English Channel, pushing the British. By the end of June, the French army had collapsed, and the nation sued for peace with Germany. Hence, Germany successfully used the Blitzkrieg tactic against Poland, Denmark, Norway, Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg, France, Yugoslavia, and Greece. Germany did not defeat Great Britain, which was protected from German ground attack by the English Channel and the Royal Navy. On 4th of June 1940, Winston Churchill delivered one of the most famous speeches of all time to the House of Commons in Westminster, in which he warned about the possibility of a German invasion of Britain. Britain withstood the German air force, called the Luftwaffe, in the Battle of Britain. But Britain was alone, and in great danger of losing the war. The Luftwaffe bombed London for 76 nights running, the Blitz, then other cities such as Coventry. People took cover in air raid shelters, some were made of corrugated iron in gardens, others were located inside train stations and tunnels. The British were driven out of Greece and most of North Africa. The British ran out of money, and had to sign the Lend-Lease Agreement with America. The Lend-Lease policy was a program under which the United States supplied the Britain with food, oil, and materiel between 1941 and 1945. This included warships and warplanes, along with other weaponry. America sold arms to Britain, to be paid back after the war. In June 1941, Hitler launched Operation Barbarossa, in which the Nazi Germany invaded Soviet Union during World War II. Insisting on the necessity of Lebensraum, living space, Hitler set up an ambitious plan to conquer Eastern Europe to find a new territory for the Germans, who he believed were superior Aryan race. Soviet Union continuously failed in the early stages of war because of its low quality of weapons. Based on three primary strategic objectives set out by Hitler in the Barbarossa, German forces were divided into three army groups. Army Group North with the target of Leningrad, Army Group Central in charge of Moscow, and Army Group South attacking the Kiev and Ukraine. Many of the Soviet cities were seized by the German army and caused tremendous damage. But due to extreme weather conditions, temperatures kept decreasing, which hampered the advance of German tanks, and the supply situation deteriorated. Germans resumed their attack on Moscow, but on 5th of December 1941 Soviet Union counter-attacked. The failure of Operation Barbarossa was the first major German defeat. In December 1941, the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor. The attack led to the United States' formal entry into World War II. Japan intended the attack as a preventive action to keep the United States Pacific Fleet from interfering with its planned military actions in Southeast Asia against overseas territories of the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, and the United States. In June 1942, the Americans defeated the Japanese at the Battle of Midway. In November 1942, the British won the Battle of El Alamein in Egypt. And in January 1943, the Russians defeated the Nazis at the Battle of Stalingrad. As a result, the Allies gradually began to win the war. In 1944, the Nazis launched V-1 rockets, known as doodlebugs, which fell randomly in southern Britain. But after D-Day, Normandy landings, on the 6th of June 1944, Germany was gradually driven back in Western Europe by the British, Americans and their allies. The Americans and British continued the strategic bombing campaign on German cities. The Russians advanced in Eastern Europe, and in April they reached Berlin. On April 30, 1945, holed up in a bunker under his headquarters in Berlin, Adolf Hitler committed suicide by swallowing a cyanide capsule and shooting himself in the head. Germany surrendered and war came to an end in Europe shortly afterwards, and Victory in Europe Day was announced on 8th of May 1945. Winston Churchill announced the victory with caution and talked about Japan, where the war continued for three more months. On 6th and 9th of August 1945, America dropped two atomic bombs on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, thus ending the Second World War. Within weeks, Japan surrendered, and Victory over Japan Day was announced on the 15th of August 1945.